Hi, I'm Tom, and I'm the Metalwork Product Manager for Solid Solutions. In a moment, I'm going to pass to Mark, and he's going to talk us through the major benefits of SolidCAM and sliding head machines. Then we'll come back and look at how we can program a sliding head machine, and finally showing it cutting live in action for us today.
Hi, I'm Mark Stocks. I am Technical Director of SolidCAM UK, so I look after all the applications side, whether it's looking after the engineers, who look after support, look after all the training, look after all the post-processor configuration here. We have obviously the Technology Centre here, and this was run for seminars and run for testing of software, so again, looking after all that side of things as well. It's an area which has seen a lot of growth over the last few years. It's always an area which has been considered like a dark art in the past, and there's very few companies can actually do it. This is still an area which is predominantly programmed, especially the sliding head, in terms of it's a lot of it's still done longhand. It's not being used, CAD/CAM's not being used for it. So it's a big area of growth where CAD/CAM can exploit, and there's very few systems which actually handle anything like this properly. So SolidCAM have invested a lot in development of the software to make sure that we support all the functionality of these machines, but also make it as easy as possible. And our sort of walk, sort of foot in the door is that we can make this then more accessible to other companies. And a lot of the time, say with sliding head at the moment, because it is being programmed longhand, they're highly skilled operators, and they're becoming a lot harder to find, and the age group of those operators and those setters or those programmers is getting higher and higher. So they are becoming becoming a lot more reliant on those, and they're now seeing a way in with SolidCAM supporting these machines of actually making it a lot more accessible so that younger people can come in. Yes, you still need to have knowledge of the machine and all the programming and everything else on there, but it gives them a way of actually supporting it as well. For sliding head, the UK I think is the third biggest market for sliding head in Europe. So it's a massive investment, massive opportunity for us to exploit. And that's also diversified into advanced mill term machines like the Mianos, the Nakamuras, the index types of machines on there, which we can then program as well. So program all consistently the same way, and that gives then the customer a good basis for all of these machines. Okay, so we're here in the SolidCAM UK Technology Centre, and as I mentioned earlier, one of the prime reasons for this is that we can show the software off and prove our claims as to, say for example, machining, we're quite often claim we can save 75% of time savings. That's a wild statement. We've got the machine there, we can actually demonstrate the savings. Exactly the same here, we're now claiming all our support for sliding head machines in different types of machine. So we've now got a Star ST20 in our Technology Centre, three turret, three channel machine, complex machine on here, superimposition, lots of things going on in such a small area. We can demonstrate how easy we can program this machine and actually cut parts on it. So that's really what we're showing here. We've invested a lot in the last couple of years in terms of background technology. So we've got guys here who will support the programs, post-processors for you, directly on here within the UK, which is something which nobody else can actually do because it is complex on there and a lot of software that has to go back to headquarters. For us, SolidCAM, no, we can do that in the UK. So that's really what we're looking at. So we've got this particular part, which we've been programming and playing around with on there, which is, say, an example part. It shows a lot of things within that. So main spindle work, sub spindle work, superimposition between upper and lower turrets on there. So we can show an awful lot in a very short time on that. And that's really what we're showing around today.
So thanks, Mark, for that great insight. So let's have a look at actually making our toolpath and then putting it on the machine. So the first thing to ask, are there any additional things that we should worry about when using a sliding head machine compared to normal mill turn? The answer is yes, but we can deal with them quite easily. The first one is that normally for a mill turn machine, we would turn the whole part and then mill the subsequent operations. It's not the case in a sliding head machine. We work in segments. And this is because of how the Z-axis works and the bush that keeps the material. From there, we also change how we work with retracts on toolpaths. Instead of going back to the top right safety corner, we might stay down or we might come out slightly. So we can show how that works really easy. And once we take some of these considerations into account, we can then make them into a toolpath, save them as a template, and that template can then be easily drag and dropped onto the subsequent features that we may want to use. So we've just talked about templates and shown how they can be dragged and dropped onto the part, making it nice and easy for us to generate toolpaths. From there, we can also do something else to speed up our toolpath making, and that is using the SolidCAM toolkit. The SolidCAM toolkit keeps all your tools as they are on the machine, so we can set the positions, the orientation, and even the specific geometry if you've got that from your tooling supplier. With the Star ST20, it has three turrets, and potentially two of those three turrets could be used at once. So how do we go about that within SolidCAM? And that's using channel synchronization. It's a really powerful tool that allows you to set which operations go after one another potentially, or in the case of today, we'll show you superimposition where we can drill and mill at the same time. The channel synchronization is a really simple tool to use. We'll just select which toolpaths we want to run at the same time, and it'll also tell us which ones can run at the same time, giving handy flags to tell us what we can and can't do.
Okay, so what you've just seen on there is obviously, or hopefully, the ease of use on there, the use of templates, drag and drops, as you say, on here. We've also got the channel synchronization, which is a big key to how all this technology works. We can obviously synchronize operations to work together very, very quickly, but we also change the way those operations work together. For example, on here, as you've probably seen in the template on the last one, you've got an upper and lower turret on there. This one's got independent Z axis on it. This has got its own Z-axis, so depending on, this could work with Z1, this could work with Z3, this could work in superimposition with Z1. So this is all controlled by the channel synchronization table and submachines within inside SolidCAM. So that's set up to make it really easy for the users, so they can just change the way the mode it works. That's also then replicated in the machine simulation, so again you can see exactly what's happening on that front. And as I say, everything's being done from this office in the UK. Okay, machine simulation on there is going to give you a good idea of exactly what's happening on the machine, so you'll be able to check how it's moving. Normal simulation inside SolidCAM, for example, would show the tool revolving around the axis of the component for C-axis, whereas this would show the actual C-axis working and show you the exact mode on there. It will also show you the superimposition, so as on this particular part, we're drilling on the upper turret while we're milling on the lower turret. So the Z3 is actually being compensated for movement of Z1. So you'll see all of that as well in the machine simulation inside SolidCAM, so you'll see exactly what's going on. You can put all the holders on there, you can populate the whole machine in SolidCAM exactly as it is on here, and then make sure that you don't have anything in the way. So for example, you can't have the second turret in the way when you move the subspindle up, and you can see that if there was any collisions on there. So yeah, it's going to give you a very good representation of exactly what's happening on the machine. Yeah, of course SolidCAM can do more than sliding heads on there. Its core business over the years, when it first started, was your standard 2.5D, 3D type milling on there. We've made that as simple, as powerful as we possibly can. We've included the eye machining, the fast metal removal on there. That's patented, and again, there's a lot of things going on in there to try and keep constant force and everything else on there, which makes it much more efficient. So that's always been the main core. Then you move on to the advanced stuff. So we've got 5-axis machines, and just over there, there will be a 5-axis machine joining us in about a month's time. So we'll be able to show all of that as well within the same technology center. We've done a lot online in terms of showing that with the support of barrel tools and things like this, and that's all being shown at the moment. Then moving on to sort of the mill turn side of it. The product has changed an awful lot over the last 10 years from the mill turn side, from, if you like, a basic XZC type of machine, now going up. There's no limit to the number of axes which we can now support. There's no limit to the number of channels we can now support. This one's 12 axis. You've got 3 channels on it. That's towards the higher end of it, but there are 4 channels out, machines out there, and we'll support those as well. So yeah, we cover the entire range.
So today we've seen the great functionality and how it is tailored to sliding head machines within SolidCAM. We've also seen how it can be proven in the SolidCAM Technology Center, as well as the templates, how we use those, the toolkit, how that references the tooling and how we can keep referencing that time and time again, and how we can replicate the machine kinematics inside machine simulation. So from all of us here, we'd like to say thank you for watching.